Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today in this video, I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of Anaconda on Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how you can easily use Spyder IDE, then Jupyter IDE, and also several other IDEs using Anaconda Navigator. So do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee you that if you are into machine learning or if you are aspiring data scientist, then this video is going to help you. So do watch the video till the end, and if you still face any issues in middle, you can always comment in our comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. Now to install Anaconda, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and to just simply search over here Anaconda download and hit enter. And you'll be seeing this www.anaconda.com as a first source link. So you need to open that link and it's going to redirect to the official site of Anaconda. So you know, I'm going to scroll down and I'm going to click on this free download button. So it's going to redirect to this page. So this download, you know, anaconda.com/download link, I'm going to put right in our description. So you can directly use that link to land over to the official site of Anaconda. So here, you can easily download our software. So depending upon what operating system you are using, Windows, Linux or macOS, you need to click on that, you know, download button for that respective operating system. For Windows, I have selected this and it has rightly started downloading our Anaconda, right? It is a 1 GB of file. So I have already downloaded it. So I'll close this. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory and here you can see that the same file is already been downloaded over here, right? So I'll just simply double click on the file in order to install it locally on our system. And you can see welcome to Anaconda setup is rightly open. So let's minimize our download directory. So here you need to just simply click on next to continue. So this is our license agreement. You can always read this. Click on I agree. And now it is telling you are installing for just me or for all users. So if you have multiple users on your system, so then you can select this. Or if you are just a single user, so in that case, which is the recommended one, is just me. So that is what I am going to select. All right. So then just simply click on next. So this is our destination folder. So on our users directory, they're going to create Anaconda 3 folder, which is totally fine. The most important part is over here. As you can see, available space currently I have is 190.9 GB. So it will take about 5.7 GB, you know, total space to install our Anaconda. So that is what you need to just care about. All other things are fine. Just simply click on next. And here under advanced options, you can see we have some, you know, check boxes. So it will, you know, going to register our Anaconda 3 as our default Python 3.11, which is recommended one. I'm not going to select this one. I'm going to keep this default. Only thing that I'm going to select is clear the package cache upon completion. So it's going to automatically recover some of our disk space without harming any functionality. So I'm going to select this fourth one and I'm going to then just simply click on install. So it's going to start installing our Anaconda. You can always click on the show details. You can see it is extracting all the files and installing it, you know, on our system. So you know, this will take some time, you know, about, you know, 10 minutes I would say. So you know, give some time, and after that I'm going to again come back to this video. So welcome back, and now then see that our Anaconda is successfully installed. But the thing is, it took, you know, significant amount of time. I would say nearly, you know, 20 to 25 minutes. I don't know why it took, so but it took. And probably it is, you know, took to clear all the cache and all that. But eventually, you know, after waiting, you will see that it is done. All right. So once you see this completed, you need to click on next over here. And now everything is set properly. Our Jupyter and everything you'll be seeing very soon. So just simply click on next and then launch our Anaconda Navigator is rightly selected. So just, you know, simply click on finish. So that will going to first redirect to your browser about the success of, you know, installing Anaconda, welcome note and everything. So you can minimize this and it will also going to start launching our Anaconda. So you can see it is rightly started initializing. You can always go to search and type Navigator So that will also show you Anaconda Navigator over here, right? And so from there also you can open. So now it is already started. And you can see that our Anaconda Navigator is rightly open. And it is also telling that, do you wish to update to Anaconda Navigator version 2.5.2? You can always do that. For now, I am going to remind me later. And then you can see this sign in. So you can always sign in. Again, for now, I'm going to cancel this. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you about, Jupyter Notebook. So that's the first one. And after that, I'm also going to show you about our Spyder IDE. So both this, Jupyter Notebook and Spyder are extensively used on machine learning and artificial intelligence. So let's first click on the launch button of our Jupyter to start launching it. Then I'm going to talk about Spyder. And it will ask you about which browser you'd like to open. So Microsoft Edge I'm going to open. You can use, whatever browser you have, Edge or, Chrome, whatever. So you can see that on our local host, our Jupyter Notebook is rightly open. So here, what you need to do is you need to hover over this new and click on this, Python 3. So that will open a new Python 3, notepad over here on a new tab. So you can see it is rightly open, an untitled project. You can give any name of your project. I'm going to give hello. And here I'm going to print hello, all right. So just use this, Python command of print. And within that, I'm going to type hello. And after that, if I click on the run button, you can see the output is properly coming. You can do all these operations of 5 plus 2, click on run, you can see the output, right? And you can start, your machine learning journey on our Jupyter. I'll minimize this. I'm going to now click on launch of our Spyder, and you can see that our Spyder is rightly launched. So welcome to Spyder. You can always click on start tour, so it will going to show you each and everything. So you can always read this, click on this next button and you can read all of that. I'm going to click on close, right? So you can see it is properly open. So this is our interface of our Spyder. So it is using 3.11 as our Python base, and here is our console, right? So this is our editor. So it has already opened one tame.py file. You can create a new file clicking on this button. You can see one new file is created. You can always go to file and again click on new file to open, or you can open any projects and you can do all of that, right? So here on a new file, what I'm going to do is I'm going to, again do that same print. If I go to file and click on save as, so I need to save this file. So on our desktop, I'm going to saving this file as hello.py. So you can see file is rightly saved. And now if I click on this run button, it will ask you whether you'd like to run the file with default configuration. Yes. And to run with default configuration, click on run and you can see the output properly on our console, right? Whatever you have written over here, so that output is coming on our console, right? And you can start your machine learning journey over here. So in this way, you can easily install latest version of Anaconda on Windows operating system. I have also showed you about Jupyter Notebook, then Spyder IDE. You can also use Jupyter Lab, this command prompt, then Anaconda Notebooks, data spill. You can also install all that. You can also launch our AWS data load. So all these things comes, whatever you can see, have a active launch button. So all those things are already installed. So but to install a new software like Art Studio, you need to click on that install button, all right? Like for PyCharm, again that install button, you need to click on and proceed with the installation of PyCharm or Art Studio. But all these softwares like Jupyter Lab, Notebook are already installed, so we have the launch button. So yeah, that's pretty much all about this video. Please do like, share and subscribe. That really help me to make more such videos. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.